Hello everybody, I hope you are all okay. Now today I will start your paper 6.5 paper on economic thought. Now to begin with economic thought, firstly let us understand about mercantilism. Okay, so what is mercantilism? So, the economic ideas and policies which were followed by European statesmen from the 15th century till the second half of the 18th century have been generally described as mercantilism. The mercantilist thought that the wealth of a nation could be increased by trade. The meaning there in the word mercantilism itself. Now mercantilism is known by various names. It is also known by bullionism. Okay, bullionism. Then it is also known as Colbertism and Cameralism. Bullionism, Colbertism and Cameralism. So these you remember these three terms. It is other words for mercantilism. The early mercantilism believed that the wealth of a nation consisted in the amount of bullion, that is gold and silver, possessed by it. So they suggested ways and means of increasing the stock of gold or silver in a country. Hence the term bullionism. In Germany, mercantilism is also known as Cameralism, Cameralism. So, it is also known as Cameralism in Germany. And in France, it is known as Colbertism, Colbertism. Okay. Now, let us discuss what are the factors responsible for the rise of mercantilism. Mercantilism grew out of the various changes that were taking place in the contemporary Europe. The following factors are responsible for the rise of mercantilism. Now, number one, economic changes. The important economic change that was reshaping the European society was the decline of feudalism and its replacement by commercial capitalism. The characteristic features of the feudal society were emphasis on local economic self-sufficiency, greater stress on local development of agriculture, small-scale manufacturing, absence of exchange economy, exploitation of agricultural workers by the feudal lords. So, as a result, manufacture and commerce was gaining importance in the economy. Feudal societies were breaking up. Then, next point, point number two, political changes. The major political change was the transition from feudalism to nationalism. In the medieval times, the society was marked by particularism. The rural areas were ruled by feudal lords who were constantly fighting with each other. The cities were led by the guilds and municipalities, which placed a number of restrictions on trade between the cities. The mercantilists were in favor of a single despot king. Then, point number three, religious changes. Reformative movement of Martin Luther was becoming popular about the beginning of the 16th century. Roman Catholic Church was being challenged by Protestantism. The Roman Catholic Church preached spiritual ideas and emphasized the detachment from money and other material objects. Protestantism developed a rational concept of religion by professing the ideas of individualism, personal freedom and responsibility. Point number 4, cultural changes. Renaissance or the movement of new light and learning also reflected the reaction against medievalism. Medieval theology had taught that the miserable condition of the human being of earth would be compensated by the proposed bliss in heaven. The characteristic feature of Renaissance was the development of humanistic attitude, which laid stress on the happiness of man on this earth. Point number 5, discoveries and inventions. Various discoveries and inventions also played an important role in the promotion of trade and commerce and thus helped in the development of mercantilist thought. Important among them were Mariner's Compass, Columbus' discovery of America, discovery of gold and silver mines in the New World, and the invention of the printing press. So, these are the following factors responsible for the rise of mercantilism. Now, let us see what are the main tenets, what are the main ideas or the main tenets of mercantilism. Okay, now the main tenets or the main ideas of mercantilism are, number 1, 5 aspects of mercantilism. Hexer. So you know what is you have heard the name of Hexer. Hexer defined mercantilism as a system of economy and emphasized its 5 aspects: as a system of economic unification, as a system of power, as a system of protection, as a monetary system, as a conception of state. Then the second tenet of mercantilism is as a protectionist and a monetary system. As a protectionist and a monetary system, mercantilism reflected a particular attitude towards goods and money. As regards goods, the mercantilists had a fear of goods attitude, and regard money, they exhibited hunger for money attitude. So they wanted to protect the money from the bad effects of having too much commodities, and on the other, they wanted to accumulate more and more gold and silver. Then number 3, trade. The mercantilists advocated the principle of balance of trade, which required the creation of surplus of exports over imports. In this way, both the objectives, that is, disposing of goods and accumulation of treasure, could be achieved through the principle of balance of trade. Number 4, commercial policy. To obtain an export surplus, attempts must be made to stimulate exports and discourage imports. So this is the modern rule also, no? In the modern economies also follow. So, various commercial measures suggested by the mercantilists were restriction on the import of manufactured goods, encouragement to the export of manufactured goods, restrictions on the export of raw materials, encouragement on the to the re-export trade, restrictions on industries which interfered with other industries or with trades of greater national importance. Point number 5, production. To increase exports, a country must make efforts to augment its aggregate output. That is, to increase its aggregate output. In other words, increasing the exportable capacity is a matter of economic growth and employment. So, aggregate output can be increased by full and efficient employment of existing human and natural resources. Point number 6, factors of production. Regarding the relative role of various factors of production, labor was given primary importance, land becomes next and capital got the least important position. Then employment. To achieve full employment of both human and natural resources was accepted as the fundamental objective of economic policy and maximization of aggregate output. Population. Population growth was considered as a favorable factor for economic development and for war purposes. Therefore, measures were suggested to increase population. Then, point number 9, wages. The mercantilists were not in agreement on the question of wage policy, but the general attitude was in favor of a low wage policy as it reduced costs and consequently the prices of production. Then money. The mercantilists had a lust for money, not because they identified money with wealth, but because they wanted to accumulate money as a treasure. Their desire to have large quantity of money was the main reason. Then value. Mercantilists considered exchange as the real source of wealth and profit. The merchant's profit originated from the trading process. It originates from the difference between selling and buying prices of goods. Now let us come to another point, that is, we have discussed about the rise of mercantilism. Now we must know what is the decline, what are the causes of the decline of mercantilism or fall of mercantilism. So we had discussed about the rise of mercantilism. Now we'll discuss about the decline of mercantilism. Mercantilism declined in England and other parts of the world towards the end of the 18th century. The main reasons are as follows. Number one, under the influence of the teachings of Adam Smith, the policy of plenty began to replace the policy of power. Number two, the development of banking, both domestic and international, reduced the importance of bullion, gold and silver and coins. Number three, the expansion of money economy showed that real estates, factories and machinery were more important items of wealth than gold and silver. Number four, the economic growth that took place during the Industrial Revolution made it possible for the society to rely on competitive forces and laissez-faire rather than promoting and regulating monopolies. Number five, the great progress made in science and technology taught people that a country could become richer not only by impoverishing the neighbors but also by mastering the forces of nature in a most efficient way. It also found that wealth of nations can be increased simultaneously. Number six, during the period of mercantilism, economic life was highly regulated. There were many regulations protecting the quality of goods. But these regulations, which were once necessary, ultimately became a barrier to progress. So the regulations were withdrawn. There are ideas and policies extant today that resemble the ideas of mercantilism. Now, this is the main of the rise and fall of mercantilism. Now, let us see who were the mercantilists. Okay, who were the mercantilists? Now, some of the mercantilists are Thomas Mann, T-H-O-M-A-S-M-U-N. He was an English merchant and he was born on, you note it down, 1571 and he died in 1641. Thomas Mann. Then J.B. Colehart was another mercantilist. J full stop B full stop Colehart. C-O-L-H-E-R-T, Colehart. He was born in 1619 and he died in 1683. He was a great French finance minister. Then Philip Wilhelm von Hornick. He was also a mercantilist. Philip, Wilhelm, W-I-L-H-E-L-M, Von, V-O-N, Von, H-O-R-N-I-C-K, Hornick. And he was born in 1638 and he died in 1712. So these were some of the famous mercantilists. Now, I will again continue with your classes on economic thought, but mostly I think you refer to the book on history of economic thought by R.R. Paul. It's okay, because this book you can again study for your 6th sem. And also there is another book written by V. Lokanathan. So anyway, when there's regular classes, then we can continue and you can come for other references and books. But now on, I will take your classes in this manner. And you listen to this again carefully and you note down the points. Thanks.